Zusammen sind wir einmalig.
Hello, my name is Anna Odesky. I'm currently 12 years old and I'm in Penny Harvest and in PS 144.
Last autumn, Anna and her class collected pennies for four whole weeks. Over 500,000 students in New York take part in the penny harvest every year. Teddy Gross, the founder of the project, shows us the penny harvest in the cellar of the Common Sense office.
This is probably a dollar right here. Citywide, that translates into $700,000, 200 tons of pennies, several herds of elephants, as children like to think about it.
Penny Harvest is the most well-known project of Common Sense and is also the largest philanthropy program in the USA. The facts. During the last school year, nearly 500,000 children in 770 New York schools took part. They collected pennies worth $700,000. Over 7,000 pupils decided how the money collected should be donated at 521 round tables. They founded 1,283 funds for non-profit organizations and their own projects. Every school gets $1,000 back, and the children themselves decide who they will donate the money to.
So I think that what really makes Penny Harvest so important is that they do every part of it and that they get that opportunity.
But Anna and her class did not only collect pennies but also toiletries for homeless people. Today, they are sorting the donations.
So we're trying to get things organized, but it's very, very messy.
Anna presents a check and the toiletries to Midnight Run, a local charity for homeless.
In little ways, we can help make a difference in this world. Midnight Run is one of the organizations that helps people really well. Midnight Run, you are wonderful.
The envelope contains a check for $650, but Anna and her friends will still continue collecting pennies. $2 billion in pennies are still waiting to be harvested in the United States.
Hello, my name is Alexandra.
Hello, I am Alexandra. I'm 13 years old. I go to school in Bloomberg, Germany.
Alexandra is a junior sports mentor in the 7th grade. Teacher Gerhard Scherer can spend more time with weaker students whilst Alexandra takes over part of the lesson.
For me and my colleagues, it's like having a young plant to look after, and we hope that it develops into a big plant, a citizen who will take over social responsibility.
No other state in Germany is more committed to social engagement inside and outside of school than here in Baden-Württemberg.
You learn to get on better with people in a team, to treat individuals properly, how not to be unfair and to how accept everybody.
The facts. Every year around 31,500 students take part in the program, with 60 to 65 school lessons per year, which have been integrated into the curriculum of the 480 secondary state schools since 2004. The pupils also work together with many third sector organizations, such as churches and foundations. Miguel also provides his social engagement in Heilbronn, painting with mentally handicapped people once a week throughout the whole school year.
Schools are not just there to educate young people in certain academic subjects, but we must also strengthen the youngsters' way of community thinking and show them that it can be important for their lives and is important for them personally that they take on responsibility for others.
Jennifer and Marco work as first aid assistants during school breaks, trained by the Red Cross. Secondary schools are now opening their doors to work together with partners in their communities.
For the community, this means, in a win-win situation, that they get young people to help them in their work, who then, after Top SE, say, we want to carry on helping, or there we feel at home.
Alexandra has already made her decision to work as a voluntary youth coach in the local sports club after leaving school.
Hello, my name is Anthony Demopoulos and I am 14 years old. This is a story in New York.
In the school computer room, Anthony and his classmates are researching on the web to find information for their project, DWI, amongst teenagers.
All these laws that are current right now, they're not really strict. So by making this project, it's like waking up America and telling them, look what's happening.
Project Citizen helps students all over the U.S. to become active citizens. They learn how to follow the course of and how to influence political decisions. The facts: 250,000 pupils and students in all 50 states take part. The program is part of the school curriculum and finance is ensured by legislation. The program is currently operating worldwide in over 70 countries.
Showing drunk driving.
Anthony and his friends are presenting their ideas to the Project Citizen Board. Students look for answers to a problem and forward them to the authorities. During the last few years, students have even convinced their state governments to pass new laws.
The politicians learn that the kids are someday are going to be a voting age, which is very important. They realize that kids do have a voice that they need to listen to.
Upstairs on the next floor, fifth graders are working on ideas on how kids can be protected against skin and lung cancer.
To put on sunscreen, stay away from people who smoke and stuff so there won't be thousands of children from the ages 5 to 12 getting cancer.
Anthony and his group will now start raising funds to support a charity which demands stronger punishment for DWI amongst teenagers.
I believe the program is so powerful and so necessary for a constitutional democracy to sustain itself. We know that civic engagement is what makes a democracy a democracy.
Hello, my name is Latia McCarthy and I'm from Phoenix High School. I'm in year 8 and I'm 12 years old.
Last April, Lydia and her school friends impressed the whole country by winning a prize for organising a community event for young people in their neighbourhood, one of the most deprived areas in London.
They can't reduce it too much. I learned that you can do anything if you put your mind to it, and that if you can achieve it if you believe in yourself, because we had a time limit of only 4 weeks and we've done it.
Citizenship education lesson plans designed by the Citizenship Foundation enable young students in the UK to learn and grow up with community engagement throughout all of their school career. The facts: 1.2 million children and youngsters in the UK have taken part in the nationwide programmes to date. Go Givers for 5 to 11 year old primary school pupils, Giving Nation for 11 to 16-year-old students, and Youth Act for young people. Citizenship Foundation programs encourage pupils with lessons designed for their respective ages how to give their time, their power, and their voice.
One of the most important things is to give young people the feeling that they're in charge, that they themselves are taking the decisions and they're not simply ticking the box on a questionnaire that is passed down to them from higher authority.
Even primary school children learn how to respect each other and how to take on personal responsibility.
Me and my family have been thinking that we could stop driving everywhere and start walking to save, help global warming.
The Office of the Third Sector coordinates all the activities of Citizenship Foundation and non-profit organisations with the governmental policies.
What we're really about is creating an atmosphere in Britain where people really feel that they can make a difference to individuals and communities, that they know where to go, that they've got that support.
Young people are working on a project to create a better understanding between young people and the police. The Youth Act program motivates young people to achieve social and political changes in their community. And Letia is already planning her next event.
I've heard her on the telephone to some fairly important people, and I must say she does a better job than I would of getting sponsorship out of people.
Last year, her teacher says, Letia was just an ordinary student. This year, she's a young lady of exceptional social competence.